In today's topic, we are going to discuss about four things. In today's lecture, we will discuss about four things. First is the velocity distribution in open channel. Second is the one-dimensional approach. Third is the energy correction factor alpha and momentum correction factor beta. So these are basically the four topics that we will discuss today. All right. So let's start with our discussion with the velocity distribution. All right. So if you have a natural cross section, suppose you take a river and you go to a river, fix one cross section there, fix a location there, do the bathymetric survey. So just measure the depth at all the points along the cross section. So you will get the depth. So and you go along the you go into the river, take some instrument with you, maybe you have some current meter, or you have an acoustic Doppler velocimeter or some velocity measurement instrument, and you measure the velocities at many locations. Suppose you go at this point and measure the velocities at several points at this along the depth, again go to some different location. So across this cross section you go, and suppose you measure the velocities, and then you plot the velocities in this way. If you try to plot the velocities, what you will see that if you join the values of same velocities, you will get something called as the isovals. Okay, isovals are the contours of same velocity values. All right, and if you observe the isovals, what you will learn that near the bank, the velocities are less near the bank because of the resistance from the bank, higher resistance from the bank. As you go to the center of the river, the velocity values go on increasing. All right, so this is one observation. Now, if you plot a variation of velocity along the depth, all right, so if you go at the center of the river, suppose, and you measure the velocities, you have already measured the velocities along the depth. So if you plot the velocities along the depth, you will get a profile. This profile is called as a velocity profile. This kind of profile, the variation of velocity along the depth of flow, is called as the velocity profile. Okay, velocity profile. Now see, velocity at all the different points on this cross section is different. All right, velocity at, let us say you take, I'll draw again here, this cross section, I'll draw in three dimensions. Okay, so this is that cross section. Okay, and this is the depth of flow. So water is flowing like this, left to right, and this is the cross section. Okay, so if you take a point here, is some small area, let us say this is area you take. Okay, this is the flow area, entire area is the flow area A. Flow area is how much? Flow area, total flow area is A. This is the cross-sectional area through which the flow is taking place. Okay, now you select a small area dA in that area, a small area dA. Now if you want to find out how much is the discharge flowing through that area, so how you can calculate that? See, if let's say dA is the small area, and in unit time how much it will travel. In unit time it should travel, the travel length should be equal to the velocity. So this small area will travel equal to the velocity. So this will be V. Okay, this will be V, because velocity of fluid through that area is V. Okay, now see, how much is the volume of water flowing in unit time through this area? In unit time, how much is the volume? You can directly multiply dA. dA is the area, okay, and V is the length. Okay, so total volume total volume of water flowing in unit time through this area will be dA into V. All right, so volume flow rate will be, or volume flow rate is nothing but discharge, I'll call it dQ. Okay, dQ will be small v into dA. Okay, small v is the velocity of that small area dA. All right, now if you want to find out the discharge of the entire cross section, discharge flowing through the entire cross section, we will have to integrate this V along the entire area. So if you integrate velocity over the entire area, you will get the discharge. But because velocity values are different at different points on the cross section, so you will, for total discharge, you will just integrate V into dA, okay, over the area A. So this will give you the discharge. Now see, here if you want to calculate the discharge, you will have to integrate the velocities. Velocities values are very different at different points, okay. But for analysis purpose, we generally use one single value of velocity, that is called as the average velocity. So for one cross section, so this is your one cross section. For one cross section, we represent the velocity of that cross section by one number. That value is called as the average velocity. Alright. Average velocity is a velocity which represents the velocity of the entire cross section. Okay. So average velocity would be how much? We average. V is equal to, you know, it is Q by A. Okay. If you consider this entire cross section, okay, and you consider that suppose V is one velocity value of this cross section, so it will be equal to discharge divided by area, isn't it? But this total discharge Q is what? Integral of V into dA over the area A upon A. So this is nothing. This is called as the average velocity. Now see, this one value we can use to represent the entire cross section, velocity of the entire cross section. Why? Because we have one assumption. Now in this case, what assumption I am making? I am making an assumption here. We are making an assumption that flow is one dimensional. Okay. Now what do you mean by one dimensional flow? Okay. So now we'll discuss one dimensional approach. Here what I have done, I have used the one dimensional approach. Why? See, if you go and measure the velocity at any point, you will get three components of velocity. If you consider three Cartesian coordinates, x, y and z directions, okay, velocity will be, so here velocity may be in this direction also, a component will be in the lateral direction also, and a component will be in the vertical direction also, okay. You will have three components of velocity, okay. But we, for simplifying the analysis purpose, we neglect these two components, that is the lateral component and vertical component, since comparatively they are negligible. As compared to this main flow direction, the component in the main flow direction, the components are negligible. So we neglect those components for basic analysis. We do not consider them, and this type of analysis in which we only consider velocity in one single direction, that is called as a one dimensional approach. Okay, we assume that velocity variation across the cross section is also, so lateral variation is negligible. Okay, so this is your one dimensional approach. But when we use the one dimensional approach, some problems can come into picture. We will discuss about those problems. Okay, so now how much is the average velocity? This is a question. So what value you should use? Okay, so you go to the river, you measure this kind of velocity profile, you have this velocity profile with you, you measure the velocity using some instrument, maybe a current meter also, current meter or something, and now you want to calculate the average velocity because you want to do some analysis. Suppose you want to calculate how much is the energy at this section. Okay, how to calculate the energy at this section? You will need the velocity. Alright, so one value of velocity you will need, that is the average velocity. So how to calculate? If you have this profile, you can use some equations, like if you have, so if y naught is the total depth, 0.2 times y naught you go from the top, that will give you V of 0.2. Okay, similarly, you go 0.6 times the velocity, 0.6 times the depth of flow, you go down from the surface, you measure the velocity. Again, you go down 0.8 times the depth and measure the velocity. So you will get these four values of velocity. Now you can use these four values to calculate the average velocity in the field. So you can use this formula, V of 0.2 plus V of 0.8 divided by 2. You can either use this formula, or V average is almost equal to V of 0.6. Okay, so if you have only one value, let us say you are only able to measure velocity at one depth.
So you measure the velocity at 0.6 times the total depth. That value also you can use as average velocity. It is very near. Both values are very near to very close. Then if you only have, let us say if you only have a surface value of velocity, surface velocity, you have some surface radar. There are instruments nowadays like radar. So the way in which we measure the traffic police measures the speed of the vehicles. In the same way, we can measure the speed of the surface water. Okay, so that is called as the surface velocity. So just point the radar at the water flow, just point the gun and measure the velocity at the surface. Okay, so if you have this value, then you can also calculate the average velocity as k into vs, k into the surface velocity value. The k, the constant value will vary between, this k value varies between 0.8 to 0.95. So this is also pretty close to the average velocity. So in this way, we try to measure the velocities and we represent the velocities by a single value, that is called as the average velocity. All right, because we are using a one-dimensional approach. Now, because of using one-dimensional approach, we have two things come into picture. That is the energy correction factor and momentum correction factor. Okay, how that will see now. Now, let us assume that, okay, yeah, the same cross section. This is a cross section, okay. I am drawing the cross section, the same cross section I will draw, suppose it is this, okay. Water is flowing from left to right. This is the depth of water. This is the channel boundary. Okay, it's the channel boundary. Now, suppose there is a small area dA. Small area. Again, we will consider a small area dA. Now, we have to define some terms before looking at the energy and momentum correction factors. First term is the, see, why, let us say you have some mass. Okay, so when we are talking about a system approach, a control mass approach or a system approach, we just consider the mass of that system. Okay, so if you know the mass, you can calculate the, let us say, kinetic energy. What is the formula for kinetic energy? Okay, how you can calculate kinetic energy? Half m into v square. So here m is the mass. All right, m is the mass. But if you have a system approach, like if you are studying the motion of a solid, suppose, so motion of this duster, suppose the duster is moving from left to right, okay, and you want to calculate the kinetic energy of this duster, what you will do? You will use the mass of this duster. All right, because it is a system approach, fixed mass. I am studying only the motion of a fixed mass, okay. But in fluid mechanics, what approach do we use? We use mostly an Eulerian approach. In Eulerian approach, mass is not fixed, volumes are fixed, okay. So what we are doing in the Eulerian approach, we are fixing this cross section, okay. We are fixing this cross section and we are studying the mass flowing through this cross section, okay. We are not following that mass, we are only looking at what is happening at this particular cross section, okay, and how much is the mass flowing through that cross section. So when we are talking about fluid flows, then we don't use mass, we come across mass flux, because if this is a cross section, flow is continuously taking place, so transport of mass is taking place, okay. So mass is being transported across this cross section because flow is taking place. So mass is going from this cross section to another cross section at every point of time. So we come across what is called as a mass flux. Mass flux is what? Mass transport in unit time. Okay, so if you have if this is area dA, mass flux through dA would be mass flux across this small area dA will be the mass transported across this small area dA in unit time. Okay, so let's try to find out what will be the mass flux through area dA. Okay, so it is the mass transported in unit time across dA. Okay, and how much will be that? How much will be that? See, mass flow rate, how we calculate? We multiply the volume flow rate into the density. Okay, this we have seen in the, earlier also. What we do, we multiply density into the volume flow rate. So what is the volume flow rate? It is V into dA. Okay, because in unit time, how much this volume will travel? This volume will travel V in unit time. So what will be the volume? Area into distance, this length. So this will give you the volume of this cylinder. So this is the volume flow rate multiplied by mass density will give you the mass flow rate. Okay, kilogram per second, you will get kg per second. Okay, so this is your mass flux through dA. So what will be the kinetic energy through this area dA? Kinetic energy, flux through area dA, that will be how much? Kinetic energy, flux. Kinetic energy is what? Half m into v square. Okay, but for in place of mass, what we should use? Mass flux, that is the mass flow rate through dA. So just use that, and it is half rho v into dA into v square. Okay, small v square. So this is your kinetic energy flux through this small area. Okay, now I want to find out the kinetic energy flux through the entire cross section. So kinetic energy, this is the actual kinetic energy. Okay, I am writing kinetic energy actual. So it is the actual kinetic energy flux through the entire cross section will be equal to integral of half rho small v cube into dA. Okay, so this will give you, this value will give you the mass, the kinetic energy flux through the entire cross section. Okay, kinetic energy is being transported through this entire cross section. How to find out? Just find the kinetic energy through small area dA, kinetic energy flux, and integrate it over the entire area. Okay, so integrate it over the entire area and you will get the kinetic energy flux. Okay, now see, if we use, now here we use the actual values of velocities. Okay, but suppose we are following a one dimensional approach. So for one dimensional approach, what is the average velocity? Average velocity is q by a. Okay, suppose q is the total discharge, a is the flow area. What will be the average velocity? V average. Suppose you want to calculate the kinetic energy flux based on this average velocity. How to calculate that? So kinetic energy flux based on average velocity, that if you try to calculate, it will be half mv square. Okay, v is the capital V average here. Okay, V average. And m will be the mass flow rate through entire cross section. It will be how much? Half. So mass flow rate will be rho a into v average square. So you are getting half rho a v average cube. Okay, so this is the kinetic energy if you use the one dimensional approach. Okay, so now these two kinetic energy values will be different. Why? Because this is the actual kinetic energy flux. Okay, actually how you if you want to calculate, then you should follow this approach. But to simplify the analysis, we use average velocity, and when we use average velocity, we are getting this value. Okay, so there is a difference between these two values, and the correction factor applied to correct the kinetic energy and get the correct value of kinetic energy, that coefficient is called as the coefficient of energy correction factor, okay, or velocity coefficient also, energy correction factor alpha. So what will be alpha?
Alpha will be equal to kinetic energy actual upon kinetic energy average. So it will be a ratio of actual kinetic energy that you calculate by measuring the velocities at different small areas and then integrating, divided by the kinetic energy which you calculate using only one value of average velocity. Okay, so that will be integral of half rho v cube dA upon half rho capital V average cube into A. Okay. So this half will get cancelled. If you assume that rho is not changing at every location, the flow is suppose incompressible, rho is also constant. So if we simplify, alpha will be equal to integral of V upon V average cube into dA 1 by A. Okay, A I'll take outside the integral because A is constant. Okay, so this is the value of your kinetic energy correction factor. Okay, so suppose now what is the use of this kinetic energy correction factor? Let's say you want to calculate the kinetic energy flux at a cross section and you have the average velocity. So what you will do, you will just calculate, I'll write it here, how to use this. Okay, so you get a cross section, suppose this is the cross section, you know the average velocity. Okay, so and you are interested in calculating the kinetic energy, so just calculate kinetic energy. Okay, I am writing it actual. What will be the kinetic energy? Just calculate half rho A into V cube, okay, but multiply it by alpha. Okay, multiply it by alpha, because then you will get the corrected value because you are using average velocity. Okay, so in this way you can use this kinetic energy correction factor to calculate the actual kinetic energy fluxes. This is also called as Coriolis coefficient. Okay, this is another name for that. Fine, now we will see in a similar way, we will see what is a momentum correction factor. Okay, so this was the kinetic energy correction factor. Now we'll see what is a momentum correction factor. Okay, now see, in the same way, now we know what is mass flux. Okay, now we know what is mass flux. So we can calculate the momentum flux also. What will be momentum flux? Momentum flux is the momentum transport through this small area dA in unit time. Okay, so what will be that momentum flux? Through dA, that will be momentum flux is momentum is what, mass into velocity. Okay, momentum flux is mass per unit time into velocity, so that is rho into V into dA. Okay, because V into dA will give you volume flow rate, multiply by rho will give you the mass flow rate, and again into V, this will give you the momentum transport or momentum flux through dA, transport of momentum in unit time. So that is rho v square into dA. Okay, now if you want to calculate the momentum flux throughout this cross section, for the entire cross section if you want to calculate, it will be momentum, I'll just write momentum actual. Okay, it represents the momentum flux across this cross section. Okay, so that will be just integrated over the entire area A. Okay, rho v square into dA. Okay, now this is the actual momentum flux, but if you want to now when we are using one dimensional approach, again you have only one value of velocity, that is the average velocity, and average velocity is total discharge divided by total flow area. Okay, now if you use this average velocity and then again calculate the momentum flux throughout the entire cross section, it will be how much? Momentum average, it will be that will be equal to mass into velocity average, okay, and mass flux or mass flow rate through this section would be rho into capital A into capital V average, okay, into V average. V average into A is the discharge, Q, and into rho, so mass flux. So that will be rho into A into V average square, okay. So this will give you the momentum flux based on average velocity. Now, but this is not the correct value, okay. Correct value is this. So this ratio beta or momentum correction factor is the ratio of momentum transport actual divided by momentum transport using average velocity, okay. So beta will be equal to, I'll just write beta here. So beta will be equal to, let's write it here, beta actual was how much? Integral of or area rho A V square, rho V square, sorry, into dA, okay. And this average is rho A V average square, okay. So rho rho will get cancelled, so beta will be equal to integral of 1 by A integral of V by V average square dA, okay. So this is your momentum correction factor. What is the use of this momentum correction factor? Suppose you want to calculate the momentum at a cross section and you apply one dimensional approach, you only have average velocity. So just use the average velocity and calculate momentum, okay, momentum actual. You need this actual value. What you will do, just use rho A V average square. This will give you the momentum flux through this area using average velocity. But what you want the actual, and this is not actual, so multiply it by the correction factor beta. So this will give you the corrected value of momentum flux, okay. So these are the energy and momentum correction factors which are used to calculate the correct energy, kinetic energy flux, and correct momentum flux through a cross section when you are using an average velocity, when you are going for one dimensional approach, okay. So these are the correction factors. The values, you can find it in any reference book, the values of alpha and beta, they are generally greater than 1, okay. So different ranges are there that you can always refer while going for one dimensional approach. All right, thank you.